10th standard history 8th lesson nationalism gandhian phase gandhian phase of india's struggle for independence non violent struggle in chambaran and against the rowlatt act the non cooperation movement and its fall out launch of civil disobedient movement issue of separate electorate and the signing of pune pact and communalism leading to partition of subcontinent into India and Pakistan. These are the main objectives we are going to see in this lesson. First, we'll see about how Gandhiji walked in South Africa to get the civil rights. Mahatma Gandhi arrived in India in 1915 from South Africa after fighting for civil rights of the Indians. Therefore, about 20 years, he brought with him a new idea to Indian politics. He introduced Satyagraha in South Africa that could be practiced by men and women, young and old. Gandhi and mass nationalism, evolution of Gandhi. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born on October 2, 1869 into a well-to-do family in Porbandar, Gujarat. His father was Kaba Gandhi and his mother was Putlibai. After passing the matriculation examination, Gandhi sailed to England in 1888 to study law. After becoming a barrister in June 1891, Gandhi returned to India. On returning to India, Gandhi's attempt to practice in Bombay, but it was failed. During this time, that a Gujarati firm in South Africa sought the services of Gandhi for assistance in a lawsuit. Gandhi left for South Africa in April 1893. Gandhi faced racial discrimination for the first time in South Africa. On his journey from Durban to Pretoria, at the Pietermaritzburg railway station, he was physically thrown out of the first class compartment. Gandhi was determined to fight. Gandhi called a meeting of the Indians in the Transvaal and advises them to form an association to justice, to seek justice of their grievances. He continued to hold such meetings. Petition to the authorities about the injustices which were in violation of their own laws. Indians in the Transvaal had to pay poll tax of $3. Poll tax, it means head tax or individual tax. According to this tax, the Indians had to pay land tax except in some areas marked for them and could not move outdoors after 9 p.m. They could not come out from their homes after 9 p.m. without a permit. He launched a struggle against like this type of the injustice laws. Inspired by Ruskin, Gandhiji established the Phoenix settlements in 1905 and the Tolstoy farm in 1910. Phoenix settlement, it means Gandhi bought 100 acres of land and made the Indians to settle in the area. That is called as Phoenix settlements and Tolstoy's farm. In that area, equality, community, living and dignity of labor were taught in these settlements. They were training grounds for the Satyagrahis. Satyagraha as a strategy in South Africa. Gandhi developed Satyagraha. Satyagraha, it means devotion to the truth or truth force as a strategy to protest against unjust laws. So he followed Satyagraha to protest against the unjust laws in South Africa. He experimented it for fighting the issues, immigrant and racial discriminations. Meetings were held and registration officers of immigrants were protested. So Gandhi and other leaders were arrested. Finally, the Smut and Gandhi agreement, the poll tax on forced laborers was abolished with the help of Gandhi. Gandhi's early satyagrahas in India. Gandhi regarded Gopalakrishna Gokhale, whom he had met on previous visit to India. On his advice, on Gopalakrishna Gokhale's advice, Gandhi traveled the length and breadth of the country before coming into politics. This enabled him to understand the conditions of the people. It is on one of these journeys through Tamil Nadu that Gandhi decided to wear a simple dhoti. Chambaran Satyagraha. Chambaran, it means name of the place which is in Bihar. In Chambaran, in Bihar, the thin kathiya system was practiced. Thin kathiya system, it means three kathas of indigo has to produce in the 20 kathas of land by the Indians. It means these were forced by the British people to produce the indigo in their land, that is in Indians' land. Under this exploitative system, the peasants were forced by the European planters to cultivate indigo on the three systems. It means three katha system. Three kathas indigos had to produce in the 20 kathas of land. That is what 3/20 of their land holdings. They increased the rent and collected illegal dues as a price for the release of cultivators from the obligations. Protested erupted. Due to that, the increased land and collected illegal dues, due to that Indians protested erupted. It means busted out. Rajkumar Sukla, an agriculturist from Chambaran, who suffered hardship of the system. So he wanted to meet Gandhiji at Chambaran. On reaching Chambaran, Gandhiji was asked by the police to leave this type of satyagraha immediately. But when he refused, he was summoned for trial. That is, he was appeared in the court. This news spread like wildfire, and thousands of gathered in the place to support Gandhiji. According to Gandhiji, the country thus had its first object lesson in civil disobedience. He was assisted by Brajak Kishor Prasad. He was a lawyer, and Rajendra Prasad, who became the first president of Indian independent. So they supported to Gandhiji in the satyagraha. Then the lieutenant governor formed a committee with Gandhi as a member, which he recommended the abolition of the thin kathiya system. So lieutenant governor also helped the Gandhi to abolish the thin kathiya system in Chambaran, thereby ending the oppression of the peasants by the indigo planters. The success of Chambaran Satyagraha, followed by Ahmed Mill strike, that is in 1918, and Kedar Satyagraha in 1918, helped Gandhi establish himself as a leader of mass struggle. Rowlatt Satyagraha and Jallianwalabagh Massacre. Rowlatt, it means name of the British officer, he passed the act. Then Jallianwalabagh, it means it is the name of the place which is in the Amritsar. So about this Satyagraha, we are going to see in this part. The Government of India Act 1919 caused disappointment as it did not transfer real power to the Indians. According to the Government of India Act 1919, the British people said that is the power has to transfer to Indians, but it was not followed by the British people. The Rowlatt Act was enacted, which provided for excessive political powers, arrest without warrant, and imprisonment without trial. That is, they put Indians in the jail. These are all hated by the Indians. So Gandhi called it as a Black Act. The Rowlatt Act, which was called by Gandhi, was Black Act. B-L-A-C-K, Black Act, A-C-T, Act. Gandhi called this Rowlatt Act was called as Black Act. And in protest called for a nationwide satyagraha on April 6, 1919. It was to be a non-violent struggle with fasting and prayer. And it was the earliest anti-colonial struggle spread across the country. The anti-Rowlatt protest was spreaded in Punjab, especially in Amritsar and Lahore. Gandhi was arrested and prevented from visiting Punjab. On April 9, two prominent local leaders, Dr. Safiuddin Kislev and Dr. Satyapal, were arrested in Amritsar because of Gandhi and Safiuddin Kislev and Dr. Satyapal were protested against the Rowlatt Act. So these three leaders were in the prison. General Dyer's brutality. On April 13, 1919, a public meeting was arranged at Jallianwalabagh in Amritsar. As it happened to be Baisakhi Day, it means Spring Harvest Festival of Sikhs, the villagers had assembled there in thousands. General Dyer, on hearing of the assemblage, surrounded the place with his troops and armed vehicles. The only entrance to the park that was surrounded on all sides by high walls was blocked, and firing took place without any warning. The firing lasted for 10 minutes. According to official report, 379 were killed and more than thousands injured. But unofficial estimates put the toll at more than 1,000 people killed by this incident. Khilafat movement. The First World War came to an end in 1918. The Caliph Turki, who was considered the head of the Muslims of the world, was given a harsh treatment by the British people. A movement was started called Khilafat movement, led by Ali brothers. Maulana Muhammad Ali and Maulana Shaukat Ali conducted this movement. Gandhiji supported the movement and saw in it an opportunity to unite Hindus and Muslims. He presided over the All India Khilafat Conference held at Delhi in November 1919. Gandhiji supported Shaukat Ali's proposal of three national slogans, that is Allahu Akbar, Vande Mataram, and Hindu Musalman Ki Jai. This was created by the Ali brothers. This was supported by Gandhiji. The Khilafat Committee meeting in Allahabad on 9th June 1920 adopted Gandhiji's non-violent, non-cooperation program. Non-cooperation was to begin on 1st August 1920. Non-cooperation movement and falls out. Indian National Congress approved the non-cooperation movement in a special session held in Calcutta on September 1920. It was later passed in the Nagpur session held on December 1920. It was conducted by Salem C. Vijay Raghavacharyar. The program of non-cooperation included, there were the 8 points, that is, surrender of all titles of honors and honorary offices. This is first point that narrated in the program of non-cooperation movement. Second one, non-participation in government functions. Third one, suspensions of practice by lawyers and settlement of court disputes by private arbitration. Fourth one, boycott of government schools by children and parents. Fifth one, boycott of legislature created under the Act of 1919. Sixth one, non-participation in government parties and other official functions. Seventh one, refusal to pay, accept any civil or military post. Refusal to accept any civil or military post. Eighth one, boycott of foreign goods and spreading the doctrine of Swadeshi. These are the 8 points narrated in the non-cooperation movement. It was chaired by Salem C. Vijayaraghavacharyar. No tax campaign and Chauri Chaura incident. So the people instructed to the Indians not to pay the taxes to the British people, and Chauri Chaura, it means the name of the place which is in Uttar Pradesh. There were hundreds of people gathered and they attacked the police station. This is what we are going to see in this topic. Gandhi announced a no tax campaign in Bardoli in February 1922. These movements greatly increased Gandhi's reputation as a national leader, especially the peasants. Gandhi made a nationwide tour. Wherever he visited, there was a bonfire of foreign cloth. So the people gathered and fired the foreign clothes in all over India. Thousands left government jobs. Students gave up their studies in large numbers, and lawyers gave up their practices. Boycott of British goods and institutions were effective. The boycott of Prince of Wales' visit to India was successful. When Prince of Wales visited India, our Indians boycotted not to enter in our country. On 5 February 1922, a procession of the nationalist in Chauri Chaura, a village near Gorakhpur in present day, it is in Uttar Pradesh, provoked by the police, turned violent. The mob, that is the people, burnt the police station. 22 policemen were lost their lives. Gandhi immediately withdrew the movement. This is called a Chauri Chaura incident. Swarajist. The Congress was divided into two groups, namely pro-changers and no-changers. Some of the congressmen led by Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das wanted to contest the elections and enter in the legislature. They were called as the pro-changers, staunch followers of Gandhi like Vallabhai Patel, C. Rajaji and others, known as no-changers, wanted to continue non-cooperation with the government. The opposition, C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru, formed the Swaraj Party on January 1, 1923, which was later approved by the special session of the Congress. Swaraj Party members were elected in the large numbers to the Imperial Legislative Assembly, that is, a member of the Legislative Assembly and the various provincial legislative councils. They effectively used the legislature as a platform for the propagation of the nationalist ideas. So Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das wanted to enter in the legislative council or assembly. Through that, they wanted to say about their motives through the legislative assembly. The Swaraj Party began to decline after the death of its leader, C.R. Das, in 1925. After the death of the C.R. Das, the Swaraj Party have declined. Constructive program of Gandhi. After the Chauri Chaura incident, Gandhiji felt that the volunteers and the people had to be trained for a non-violent struggle. As a part of this effort, he focused on promoting Khadi, Hindu-Muslim unity, and the abolition of untouchability. He said the Congress people, go throughout your districts and spread the messages of Khadar, Hindu-Muslim unity and anti-untouchability. He made it compulsory for all Congress members to wear Khadar. the All India Spinners Association was formed. Boycott of Simon Commission on November 8, 1927. The British government announced the appointment of Indian Statutory Commission, composed of 7 members, headed by Sir John Simon. In the commission, there were no Indians. Only all British people were there. So Indians were angered and they wanted to boycott the commission. All sections of India, including the Congress and the Muslim League, decided to boycott the commission. Wherever the commission went, the Indians were protested and they carried the placards. In the placards, they've written, "Go back, Simon." So the protesters were brutally attacked by the police people. In one such attack in Lahore, Lala Lajpati Rai was seriously injured and died after a few days later because of the police attack. Nehru Report. A committee under the leadership of Motilal Nehru was formed to outline the principles on the basis of which the constitution was to be drafted. The committee's report, known as Nehru Report, he recommended like dominion status for India. First one he reported to the British people, that is first one was a dominion status for India. Second, election of the central legislature and the provincial legislature on the basis of joint and mixed electorates. Third, reservation of seats for Muslims in the central legislature and in provinces where they are in a minority, and for the Hindus in northwest frontier province where they were in the minority. That is, reservations of seats for the Muslims in the central legislature in the provinces, and like in the Hindus, the northwest frontier provinces should be allowed for the reservations of the seats for the Hindus. Next one, fourth one, provision of fundamental rights and universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise, it means after 18 years they should get the rights to vote. After that, Jinnah demanded that 1/3 of the seats to be reserved for Muslims. Dej Bahadur Sapru supported him and agreed that it would make no big issues, but it was defeated in the all party conference. So what Muslims asked, that was not accepted by the party. Later he proposed a resolution which came to be known as Jinnah's 14 points programs, that also rejected. Jinnah was represented as ambassador of Hindu Muslim unity. Thereafter changed his stand and began to adopt the cause of a separate nation for Muslims.